Okay, so megasuperdbz fan requested this. I requested that I draw Vegeta and talk a little bit about how to do it. And I'm not the best. There are lots of people who are better than me, but I'm gonna try. So what I first do is I draw a circle, and then I draw the jawline, and I draw an eye line, and then put the eyebrows in, and usually I do a line down the middle of the head so I know where to put the mouth and the nose and stuff. And so I put that in now, and I realigned the eyebrows. I finished up each eyebrow. Then I add the eyes. So now I do the nose. And he's smirking in this one. And then I do the hair or the scouter inside his face. Draw the hairline. And then I draw his ear. I had a bit of difficulty with this. I'm not really good at ears. But, you know, people make mistakes all the time. And it's easy to fix them. So I draw the rest of the hair. It takes a second. It's not very hard. You just gotta look at the shape of his hair and try to get as close to that as possible. So I've got his hair finished, and I start on his neck because the neck will lead into the shoulders and then the rest of the torso. And he's wearing his Saiyan armor, so I've got the suit underneath the armor, and then the armor itself. And I'm drawing the outline for that. I made a couple of mistakes, but nothing wrong with erasing. I do it all the time. I draw the hex underneath his uniform. Draw the muscles in his neck, and then I made the outline of the uniform, which becomes the it's also the outline for the armor. And so he also has those little lines underneath his eyes, like his cheeks. Then I draw the armor. Okay, so here I made a mistake. I do that a lot. And I ended up having to redraw the most of his torso. I didn't account for how big his arms actually are, and it got a little cramped up. So his armor is actually pretty easy. It's basically just, it's like flower petals, and like his neck is where the center would be, and then you've got the two petals on the chest, and then the two petals on his shoulder. And really, when you're drawing, what I worry about the most is just putting these lines in the right places. That's all drawing is to me. It's just putting this line in the right place. So whenever I draw, I don't think about making it look like Vegeta until I've got all the base down. Once I've got a base, then I, you know, make it look like Vegeta. And I usually start tuning on that once I start to shade. And I really don't know what to say on how to draw it. But like I said, whenever you draw the armor, think of it as petals, flower petals. Whenever you're drawing Vegeta's hair, I like to think of it as like a flame. And it just gradually builds up to the tip. And his face, he's got the different eyes than a lot of the characters in Dragon Ball Z, and they're lower on his face than a lot of characters. And he's always frowning, he's always got the dip between his eyebrows, that V. So he's angry, but, you know, he's got a smile, so he's being cocky right now. And I'm using marker to do the outlines and his hair, because I like the way it looks. It looks a bit nicer sometimes. And now you can see his face a little bit better. And I made a mistake, and I didn't catch it when I was first doing it, but his jawline is a little lopsided, I guess you'd say. Like, one side's longer than the other. I usually look for those mistakes, but I was trying to hurry on this. Outline his hair. I was going to, you know, do the different shades and all, but I figured it would... It looks nicer to me when I don't. And I used a thick black marker to color in his hair. And I'm sorry that you missed a lot of the shading. My iPod, I forgot to clear the videos that I had done before. So a lot of the shading on his face, all the shading on his face and then the coloring in of his hair, it's gone. I just can't show you that again. But I did get all of his chest and stuff outlines. Now I'm working on on shading in the rest of them. The scouter I didn't outline because it's just a clear piece of glass. All I did was I shaded it darker than the rest of his face, and I don't know if I do it in the video, but I do know for sure that I outlined the scouter with just pencil, so you can see it easier. And when shading in the armor, well, when shading in anything really, what you need to do is go, what I do anyways, you don't have to do this, it's just what I do, go from the darkest point to the lightest point, just like draw the outlines of what the shading is going to be, and then go from dark to light, and that way you can rub in the dark to the light. And it was a little harder for me to get all the shades to look even because I was using cardstock, and for some reason it was different than paper. I've never done that before, the shading anyways. I always use cardstock marker. And right now I'm pretty much improvising all the shading on his chest, because in the original picture that I was using to draw him looking at, he had his arms crossed, but like I said, I got a little mixed up and didn't realize how cramped it looked, so I had to erase all of his arms and then improvise what they would look like. I looked at actually a picture of Uzar or Vegeta to get the rest of his armor done, and I pretty much just improvising from different pictures that I've drawn on his armor and how to shade it. And I think it looks okay now that I think about it. And for his uniform, it's that dark blue, so definitely make it darker than everything. His muscles, try to shade around those to where they don't look just like lines, but to where, you know, it's muscle. And once you're done, just clean up all the spots. Put your initial and your end date, and you're done. I hope this helped. Thanks for watching.